year and a half ago, I posted a video where I showed a computerized chessboard that I had made. Now there's a new version of the hardware, and I'd like to show you this. Let's power it up. Okay, so it's running test software because the new hardware requires me to rewrite some of the software, which I haven't done yet. But this test software at least proves the hardware is working. As you can see, all the squares that have chess pieces on top of them are lit up. And if I move a chess piece, the light changes as well. So that proves that all the magnetic sensors are working and that all of the LEDs are also working. Well, let's open it up and take a look inside to see what's changed. This new version has a 2-inch color LCD display with a resolution of 320 by 240. The test software displays a chessboard and allows the user to select a chess piece with the buttons and move it to another square. Let's see what's under the hood. I designed this new printed circuit board using CAD software called Easy EDA, which runs in a web browser. From Easy EDA, I exported a Gerber file and uploaded it to JLC PCB, a Chinese company that fabricates PCBs. It cost under $70 US to fabricate the minimum order of 5 boards and $40 to ship them. It took only 7 days to arrive from the time it was ordered. When ordering, you can choose between various colors. I think the black color looks great, especially with the dark gray acrylic top. This new version uses a Raspberry Pi Pico 2W microcontroller. Actually, I'm using a compatible Pi Moroni product with more features, such as a USB Type-C connector and additional memory. The USB Type-C connector can handle more current than a micro USB connector. The LEDs can draw a significant amount of current, particularly if they're all lit. I'm not sure if the final software will need to turn on all of the LEDs, but I wanted to allow for this. I'm also not sure if the final software will need the additional memory of the Pi Moroni Pico Plus, but I wanted flexibility. It is difficult to see in this video, but the area under the chessboard has an array of 64 Hall effect sensors. The new version uses sensors that are significantly more sensitive. They can detect the type of magnet I am using at a distance of 15 millimeters, as compared to 10 millimeters for the previous version. The additional 5 millimeters allows the chess piece to be detected even if it's not centered on the square. I'm using the same 5 meters of RGB LEDs that were used in the previous version. So that is a quick tour of the new chessboard hardware. I hope to have updated software soon. Please check the links in the description, and thank you for watching my video.